Hey yo, what's up guys, welcome back to my channel, Tambe here, and in this video I'm going to tell you guys how you can obtain your Hakushini ring weapon, which is a free to play weapon in Inazuma update. Well, to be noted that this video has been speeded a little bit so that you guys won't waste your time, and I have cut the scenes of talking and fighting also, and watch this video fully so that you guys have an idea what you should expect in the future. And while you're doing the quest also, watch this video again so that you don't have any doubts. And while you're doing this quest, watch this video. So let's get into the tutorial. The story quest starts with the near the Konda village, near that teleportal waypoint. There will be the girl, and next to her will be the statue. Go and talk to the girl, and she will tell you to use your electro character to power up that wolf statue right next to her. Use your electro character to power up that wolf statue. After you do that, that wolf statue will drop some gadget or a item. Pick that item and you will have to go to the nearest Konda village teleportal waypoint. After you teleport yourself to the Konda village, you will have to go to the right side where you will see a girl. Like, see over there, there is the teleport waypoint. From the teleport waypoint, turn to your right side. There will be a little girl waiting for you. Talk to that girl. I will not show you the talkative part. I am skipping and editing that. Talk to that girl, and right next to her or opposite to her, there will be a grandpa. Go and talk to him. He will also give you some quest or something to do and obtain some of the stuffs. As I said, I have edited all the talking part, so you won't see those parts. After that, you will have to go to this area or to this hut, and above that there will be a boy doing something. Talk to him, and he also will give you a quest to do. Not a quest, he will tell you to bring some items or related to that grandpa. So you will have to talk to all those three NPCs. After that, you will have to go to this lake or river, whatever it is, and there you will find some valuable item which is required for this quest. After obtaining all of that, you will have to go straight in this path where you will find some helichels. You will have to kill those helichels, and after killing them you will get some materials or an item. As I said before, I am not showing all of the fight, so I'm just showing the cutscenes. As I had killed all those helichels, I got an item, and after that, when I'm returning back, I will show you guys a granny that you should meet. And that is this granny. You should meet her, and she will also give you some quest and items to bring to her. After you talk to all of the NPCs, you will have to come to this well, and backside of that well there will be a investigate button. Press that, and there will be a talking scene which I have edited. After obtaining all the materials from the investigation, go back to this grandpa and talk with him, which I'm not going to show. You will have to give him some of the stuffs. Some of the stuffs are which you have obtained from the well and through the river, and after defeating the helichels, you will have to give it to this grandpa, or you can see what all I am giving to this grandpa. After you give these three stuffs to the grandpa, you can go up to his roof where he will be keeping his diary. I don't know why he keeps his diary on the roof. After you go over there, you will have to read his diary, and then you will have to go back to the location where you killed the helichels and defeat those other enemies. After killing all of those enemies, you will get 10 item after killing them as a reward, which will be a key. Yeah, it will be an old key which you will have to utilize to open up that well. You will have to use that key onto this well, which will unlock the main passage, and you will have to go inside this well, and it will be like a mini dungeon. There will be 3 or 2 chests in this dungeon, which I'm not going to show you guys because this video is for to how to obtain the weapon, not the chest. So open that rock over there or destroy that rock over there, and you will have to go through a passage. And when you go through the passage, you will find a electro sealy. Don't follow that sealy, it will just distract you, and you will go and find the chest and not the main point. From here, go to the left side and not follow the sealy. I repeat, don't follow the sealy, just go to the left side, and there you will find this electro ganum. Obtain this electro ganum and you will be able to walk through this shield easily, and it will not affect. After you enter the cave, you will have to do a mini puzzle, which will be kind of tough if you don't have a guide, but I am the guide here, so it's gonna be easy. And I'm going to show you guys the screenshot of that, which is this 1 2 3 4, which you will have to turn on. Like, these are the electro, I don't know what to call it. Just you will have to go to this mechanism and turn it to 1 2 3 4, the above part, the electro icon. I will call it the electro icon. You will have to turn the electro icons to the specified number I showed you in that screenshot. After you have done all of that, you will have to come to the start point and press the pray button. If you have successfully turned on all the mechanisms correctly, then a enemy will spawn in front of you, which you will have to defeat, which I'm not going to show you. After you defeat, there will be a cutscene of talking. After that, everything is done, you will get the next story part. In this cave only, you will have to find a lost key, so follow my path and do as I do. So I'm going to go over here and obtain that electro granum or whatever that it is called, and I will climb up this rock and I will go through this barrier, and above this barrier there will be some stuffs. You will have to open this gate first. After that, you will find some stuffs, and in that you will find the lost key or the key, whatever it is. I'm just going to obtain it, and here you will also obtain a electroculus and some chest, which I'm going to skip and not show you guys. If you want to, you can explore that area much more, but I don't want to because the video will be lengthy. After that, you will have to teleport to this location and glide till a certain spot. And after you glide till a certain spot and go down, you will have to do another puzzle. So this whole quest is puzzles, and if you don't watch this video fully, you will be stuck in a certain part of the video or in certain part of the story quest, and you cannot move further. My phone is a potato phone, so the graphics didn't load, so adjust. After coming over here, you will find a ghost and she won't talk much, so you will just have to follow her and she will show you some of the patterns or something like that. So just follow this ghost and I will tell you what all you will have to do and which ghost you should interact. So talk to this ghost next, and then you will have to go uphill and talk to another ghost over there. You will have to talk to this ghost, and over here you will also find a electroculus. After talking to this ghost and obtaining that electroculus, you will have to go from this location to the downer path. While you're going, you will also see another ghost. Don't talk to that ghost, just leave her all alone, and you will find a ghost near this path, and you should talk to this ghost and not that ghost which was behind. If you talked with that ghost, you will have to do this story quest, not the story quest, this puzzle part all over again. So I'm not going to talk with this ghost. There will be two ghosts by now which are guarding something. We will just leave them all alone, and you will have to come to this area, climb up this house, and you will find another ghost which you will have to talk to. After talking to this ghost, you just glide down the hill, and there near a tree you will find another ghost. Go and talk to her, and don't talk to these two ghosts. Please don't talk to her. If you do, then the whole puzzle will be screwed and you will have to start from the beginning. This is the third ghost which is near the tree. After you do this, you will be able to obtain your reward, the three chests, and there will be a note for you. After collecting all the chest reward, go and read the note. After reading the note, there will be a location set to you that will be near the sakura tree or the sakura tree. Go near the sakura tree, then there will be a gadget that you will be able to obtain from this girl, which is known as the memento lens. This memento lens will be able to help us in proceeding in with our quest. So after obtaining that memento lens, you will have to go back to the place where we came from right now, and we will have to search for some more ghosts. After arriving to the location, you will have to scan these type of rocks which look like a wolf. After you scan these types of wolf or the rock, there will be a talkative scene which I'm going to skip obviously. And after you scan all these rocks, there will be another quest or the continuation of this quest. There will be the rock, another rock over here to the right side of you, which you will have to scan over again. After that, you scan this rock, you will have to go up the hills. There will be another rock over there, right next to this. So you will have to scan this rock over again, and there will be a talkative scene which I'm going to skip. After that, you will have to go back where we got the treasure chest or all of the three chests. Over there will be another rock like this, which you will have to scan. After scanning that rock, you will have to go back uphill, and there will be another rock over here which you can scan. There is nothing like the order that you should scan these rocks and then that rock. There is nothing like that. You can scan any type of rock which you want, but you should scan all of them. That's it. After scanning all of them, you will have to come back over to this big wolfy dude and investigate. When you're investigating this wolf, he will ask you some three questions, or I don't know if it is to unlock the seal, and the order is like 1, 2, 3. So the Paimon character will ask you some questions, and the answer is in 1, 2, 3 order. After you answer to all the questions, this wolf rock will give you a item which you will have to use, and you will purify some more puzzles, or you will have to do the puzzle thingy which you did last time over again. So don't forget to obtain this item, or else you will have to come back all the way to this place and get this item, because I forgot that I had to pick up this thing, and I had gone down and I came back. This is another puzzle dungeon, so you will have to open this with a key, and there will be a electroculus which you can obtain. And after obtaining that, you will have to go to this, and I'm going to share you guys the screenshot of that puzzle. So 1, 2, 3, 3, 3. All the three are three electro signs. I don't know what to call that. So go near that mechanism and turn that mechanisms into the desired number you want. So it was 1, 2, 3, 3, 3 as I remember. So turn all of those mechanisms to the number required, and you will be able to pray, and you can continue to the next quest, and you will have to fight the boss again.
not the boss, the enemy.
After you defeat the enemy, you will just have to exit through the cave, because you don't have to teleport to the next location, because the next location is very near and you can just walk it to over there, and you will have to defeat this abyss mage also. After defeating this abyss mage, just go up the hill or just follow the staircase or the stairs and unlock this teleport waypoint if you haven't till now. And after unlocking this teleport waypoint, as I said, just follow the stairs. And when you come to the top of this stairs, and where the stairs just stop, just turn to your left and there you will find these enemies which you will have to kill. After killing all of them, come to this statue or this rock and talk to this guy known as the Loroi. And after talking to him, you will have to go back downhill, and while coming up you saw an animal, so you will have to interact with that animal and he will be able to help you in completing this quest. While you are going down these stairs, that animal will pop up again and you will have to interact with it again, and it is quite tricky. It is trying to trick you, so just follow it and don't use your electro character to lit up some stuff. Use your pyro character, don't be a fool like me. After doing all of that, you will have to go back down till the teleportal waypoint. When you are at the teleportal waypoint, you will just have to follow the quest, or you can just go to the left side where there is the river and this rock or the electroculus and kill these enemies. After killing these enemies, there will be an option for investigation. After investigating and obtaining that electro sigil, just turn to your right side and go straight. Over here you will find that animal over again, and he will be dancing and playing some music. Or if you could not find this animal, so just turn on your volume, he will be playing some music and you will be able to catch him easily. Just follow him wherever he goes, and over here he will go to the river, so just go straight and he will be inside the river or at the river. And you will have to follow him back again. Just go straight over here. I'm just a fool deciding where to go. And over here there will be some three light sticks which you will have to light up. After lighting up, the animal will die or go back to its original spot. And the original spot is at the uphill. So you will have to go back all the way up and meet that rock dude and interact with him. After you talk to this dude, you will have to go to a certain location which he will tell, and go to the Kamisato Ayaka location or the teleportal waypoint and just follow me. After you come to this location, there will be a cutscene which I cut it, and you will have to do a puzzle over again. How's that? So totally there will be around 4 to 5 puzzles which you will have to do. So you will have to watch this fully. I know it's sad, but there is nothing I can help you with. So this is the screenshot or the pattern that you will have to follow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 4. Like, just follow the pattern, dude. over here, don't change this mechanism because the electro science is correct, so you don't have to change it. After matching the mechanism's pattern, you will have to defeat the enemy and come back to the Kamisato Estate teleportal waypoint. From there, you will have to follow me wherever I go. After you come near this tree, you will have to use your memento lens to reveal the hidden statue that you cannot see. After doing that, use your electro character to obtain the item you want, and don't forget to obtain the item because I did and I had to come all the way back. So after obtaining the item, you will have to come to this. You may fight these enemies or you might not, it's all left to you. I'm just going to summon Wave Rider and I'm going to leave all these enemies over here and I'm just going to sail with the boat and go to the nearest island. After you come to this island, just follow me and use your memento lens in this location and this pathway will be opened. Don't forget to obtain your electro sigil. After obtaining your electro sigil, just go down and obtain that electro granum so that you don't be affected with the electro radiation. And there will be another puzzle over here which you will have to solve. And don't worry, I have the screenshot which I'm going to show you guys right now. Go near the puzzle and offer it whatever it needs, like this thing item. And it will open the puzzle. This is the pattern, so follow the pattern, and this pattern is very easy, so you don't have to worry very much. After completing the puzzle and defeating the enemies, you will have to come to this location. In this location, there will be two puzzles which you will have to solve. Two of the puzzles will require the electro character. So if you have the electro character, I mean the main character, you can use the main character if you don't have any of the other electro characters which will be useful for you. So use your electro main character in this. The first puzzle will be this, which you will have to change in the correct direction. So normal hits will change the puzzle's block. For this, I'm going to use Fissure. So if you use your charge attack or the electro attack, both the blocks will turn. So if you use your normal attacks, one of the block will only turn. So I'm just going to use my charge attack and turn one of the electro thingy to one side, and after that I'm going to do my normal attack so that only this part will turn, and there you go. You will just have to hit and trial, so it's all left to you and your brains. I just did it like this. It might take you some tries, don't worry, you will get over there. And don't forget, you will have to activate this thing also. It's just like a camouflage. I also had forgotten it, and then I remembered and I came and did it again. After doing that, you will have to come near this tree. Over near this tree, there will be another electro thingy which you will have to activate. After activating that, just go uphill, and over there will be another one. After activating that, come back and go downhill. Over there you will have to defeat one enemy and after defeating that enemy you will be able to activate that electro thingy. After activating all of those electro stuffs, you will have to go back near the tree and you will be able to activate a mechanism, which I will show you how to activate or where that mechanism is. That mechanism is located under the tree or near the tree. So just go over there and turn on the activate button or the start, and you will have to climb up the tree. So you will have to go inside a dungeon. So just climb up the tree, and over here there will be another puzzle which you will have to solve, and this puzzle is very easy. So use your memento lens to activate or solve this puzzle. From this point, I'm not going to give you guys the voiceover, because from here it's quite easy and I have already told you some of the basic stuff, so it's not that difficult. But at the end I'm going to give you guys the voiceover, because at the end it's a final boss fight which is not hard, but the puzzle is hard, so I will have to give you guys a voiceover at the end. So until then, peace out. So in a few moments you will fight the main boss, so you will have to equip your main team rather than your exploring team. So go and switch over to your main team, and the boss is not that hard. It's easy, but the puzzles are hard and you will require your gamer moves to win over this boss. You will just have to fall from that location to this location to that hole. I don't know why I feel like that is a butthole, but you will have to fall to this hole. While you are fighting the boss, there will be 3 stages as usual. So the first stage will end at 75% and the second stage will end at 50% and the third stage will end at 25%. So you will have to defeat or deal damage to the boss for 3 to 4 times. Now I'm going to show you guys the pattern of the mechanism, and the pattern is quite easy and you will have to follow it in order to so that you will be successful. And talking about the boss, when you enter this boss arena, there will be a mini boss which you will have to defeat. After defeating him, you will have to do this pattern. After you do this pattern, the main boss, which is known as the Masonic, I don't know what it is called, this boss will fall down after you do the pattern. So when he falls down, you can deal a whole lot of damage and he will stay there till he gets the damage till 75%. So put all of your might and deal a whole lot of damage, and don't forget to equip this thingy which will protect you from the electro radiation. After you do the pattern correctly, the boss will fall down and you can deal the damage till 75%. After that, you will have to do the pattern second time, and this is the second pattern after the boss HP is below 75%. So you will have to do it like this. The left side will be 2 electro signs, and down that will be 3 electro signs, and you will have to go to the opposite side, which is the 4th sign, and you will have to go straight down, which is the 5th sign. So after you do this, there will be another round at 25%, and I'm going to show you guys the pattern for that also. After you reach the boss HP to 25%, you will go back up and you will have to do the pattern over again, and this will be the last pattern. After this, we will not face him again. So this pattern is quite easy, 2-2 on the opposite sides and 3-3 on the opposite sides too. So it's quite easy. After doing this, you will get the weapons blueprint, the catalyst weapons blueprint. I hope you guys like this video. Please like, subscribe and share, and share it with your friends so that they can obtain this blueprint also and use it on their new catalyst characters or the present catalyst characters. I think I have made this video more informative and very less short, because I didn't want to waste all of the players' time, precious time. So until next time, peace out.